Yeah. When the ball goes up, we gotta get it. We gotta get it first. Because, you know, like, you know, we gotta make a team like tonight, but, you know, the Suns was out of game. It was small. You know, another team was big, and we had no way to play because we had to get big step for Isaiah and TP and out. So, we gotta get it first. Our guards, you know, our bigs, we gotta make contact first to try to keep those guys open up.
Do you have a good sense, like, early in the game, that you didn't have a physical performance for the team?
I really don't.
So many guys cycling in and out of the lineups around the league in the last month. How has that changed kind of how you approach game prep and scouting internally, whether you're talking to advanced guys or your assistant coaches?
You know, it shouldn't change much, but, you know, you do have different teams. And so offensively, you know, you have to build it down and not do as much. And, you know, offensively, you haven't been as good, you know. So I think more than anything, it's hurt us offensively of just having to execute, having guys in different positions. I'm having new guys that, you know, I just met a couple of days ago because I was in COVID protocol. And so it's really hurt us offensively and not being able to put two guys on the basketball with Kawhi and G and double team and offensive. It's made it tough for us. So we got to be able, like I said, in stops, convert, transition. We got to do a better job in the half court and make the quick decisions. But it has been difficult, it has been tough, but yeah, we got to work our way through it.
Different is it this year? But how much can you take away game to game, like tonight, as a coach, given that you have so many guys in and out around the league?
I think just how we play. You know, you never want to lose, but if you lose playing the right way, I mean, feel good as a coach. If you're doing the right things defensively, if you're doing the right things offensively, you just can't make shots. Like, we just started out 1-4. We talked about playing the right way, we just can't make shots. If you see the way the teams are playing, we're playing the right style of basketball, then you feel good about that. That's my game, how we're playing. Not really, well, it is really good. It's a loss, but you know, if you lose a game, you play the right way, you can live with that.
Hey, Coach, what about this particular group of guys, what have you learned from these guys this so far this season, again, with all the ups and downs that you guys just kind of endure?
We're scrapping and beat every single night, you know, no matter who's on the floor. Even 10-day guys, they come in, they scrap and compete. And so I think it's the culture we set, you know, around here that, you know, no matter who's in the game, you know, we get a chance to play, an opportunity to play. We always feel we have a chance to win. We always make the team play hard. And that's the biggest thing I see.
That's two things real quick. One is Eric and Reggie starting to go through again today.
No.
Who started in that place?
Can't remember.
Okay. I was actually want to follow up. It's the thought of those two playing together again. Obviously, we broke them up last month and have been trying to get their own unit. Just what you thought made your decision to break them up again today?
Just like I said before, job. When Rich went down, he started. That was on me. I thought he did a great job. So I'm just putting him in a position where he's more comfortable.
Thank you,
Coach. Guess
we're
going to have
Evan.
You got a big job today, don't you?
Oh, my goodness. Putting me on the spot.
You didn't know that, huh? Tell what you got to do today, Christina.
She's nervous.